morning.
Good morning.
To see you all out there on this Friday. Friday's.
Oh, a nice foggy Friday. I like this.
Think it'll stay that way all day?
Nope. No way.
Good.
You're going sailing, I know.
It'll
sunny and calm, I'm sure of that. Speaking of sort of sporting expeditions, there's been so much talk about the all-women's assault on Annapurna, which was met with both triumph and tragedy. But right here in California, there's been some...
You got those jeans, comme-ci, comme-ça. You savoir faire is oh la la. I got jeans, but aren't you new? I'd cut my jeans for you.
Well, it's that time of year when we're readying our homes for ghosts and hobgoblins. I don't know if you believe in them, but Katrina McClave has some questions about them, and she's been chasing them down to get some answers. Katrina?
Some people admit to believing in ghosts, others don't. But it would be fair to say that most people are intrigued by a ghost story. Marriott's Great America has reported ghost sights all 3 years of the park's existence. The sightings were reported by two facilities workers. I wanted to interview them, but one had since left, and the other was very reluctant to be interviewed about the sighting. I decided to pursue the story anyway and drove down to Marriott's Great America.
This is Theatre Royale at Marriott's Great America. It is the children's theatre, and I'm here chasing a story with a twist. I'm chasing the ghost of a little girl. I had heard that a little girl has been seen here on various occasions, right here on this stage, and I asked Suzanne Wilson of Great America to investigate it for AM San Francisco for the very first time. Suzanne, can you tell us what you've discovered?
Katrina, our little girl has visited us before, but the latest sighting that we've had was July of this year, and some of our employees discovered her. What happened was, he entered through the left side stage door to clean about 4 o'clock in the morning, and he heard some noise on the stage like tapping. And he looked around the stage and he saw a little girl dressed very nicely, just dancing away on stage with all the lights off. When he turned on the lights, she vanished. We've since then had other sightings where the men will come into the theater and turn on the lights and she'll stay. Obviously, that's panic, some of them, and we've tried to catch her in motion and haven't been able to do so. So I thought I should call in some extra help. I called a psychic long distance over the telephone and explained basically what was seen. She told us that the little girl was wearing a white eyelet dress. She told us about her little cream-colored boots, which told us of the era she lived. And she told us that she wasn't on stage to perform at Great America because she realized this is a theater. She was here to preserve days gone by. And from that, I discovered that this land used to be just orchard. We're hoping that either she loves us so much she's living in our theater, or maybe she played once in the orchard.
That's a wonderful story, Suzanne. Thank you for saving it for people, Chase.
Thank you.
Who is this?
This is Tasmanian Devil. And he's another one of our spooky characters we have here for Halloween Spooktacular, October 28th and 29th at Great America.
Well, he might look spooky, but he sure is friendly.
He sure likes you, doesn't he, Katrina?
I love him. Well, folks, that's it from Great America today.
Well, there may or may not be a ghost down at Great America, but that very healthy-looking little ghost was actually Katrina's daughter, Leslie Kate.
Oh, is that who
adorable.
That was?
Yeah, she came in and danced, and on one take, you know, all the times we have to
practice. One take, huh?
One take. She did
can
her
do this
dance
show
and song.
Anytime. One take. One
and there's
take
the Kate. Proud stage mother right there.
She's not a professional dancer, but she does love to dance, so it was fun for her.
It was obvious.
It's the best kind.
It was a cute story. Lots of things coming up next week.